You know, my favorite smell in the world is the smell of the earth just after it's rained. It's a smell we've all grown up with in India, just as we've grown up with the monsoon, with splashing in puddles, with getting wet on the way to school, with enjoying the rain. Now, you're gonna say that's all very well, but can you really go on vacation during the monsoon? Yes, you can. Here are some tips. First of all, you can go to Goa. Now that's probably the best time of year to go to Goa because the brown foliage becomes a lush green. The white churches are battered by the rain. And the beaches take on a golden sheen. So that's tip one. Tip two is if you're not that wild about going to Goa because you've been there, go somewhere off the beaten track. Go to Baikal. It's where Karnataka ends and Kerala begins. It's a relatively unknown destination. There's a backwater and there's a beach. You can just sit on the beach, stare out at the Arabian Sea, hear the ocean roar and feel wonderful. But you don't have to go just for beaches. You can do more. And that's tip three. You can go to Mahabalipuram. It's not very far from Chennai. You can drive directly from the airport. Once you get there, you see centuries-old temples at the very edge of the blue waters of the Bay of Bengal. Stay there, enjoy the beach, enjoy the culture, enjoy the history, and realize why we are proud to be Indians. But of course, you don't have to go to the beach. There are other places you can go to. And that leads us to tip four. You can go to the mountains in the monsoon. For example, you can drive to Missouri. Now, Missouri is a hill station that's still relatively unspoiled. It's green, it's beautiful. You can look up and see tall trees, or you can look even higher and see the mist-covered mountains. If you don't want to go to Missouri because you're on the other part of India, there's my final tip. Go to Shillong. Shillong has no airport, and there's a reason for that. It's always too misty. When you go to Shillong, you'll feel you're living within the clouds because it's hard to tell where the mist ends, the clouds begin. There are mountains, there are lakes, there's greenery, and there are wonderful hotels, not very expensive, dotted all over Shillong. And so, these were our monsoon tips on the Great Indian Safari. If you want to ask me any more questions, ask me. In fact, ask me anything.